Hi, my name is Guy Wallace. I'm a member of ASQ's Influential Voices, and I'd like to respond on video this time to Paul Borowski's post asking, how do you sell quality? In his March 2012 post, ASQ CEO Paul Borowski asks, how would you sell quality? How do I convince senior executives, often CEOs, and public officials that quality is important and an essential strategy for pick your ending, performance excellence, competitiveness, growth, sustainability, survival, efficiency, effectiveness, or all of the above? If enterprise executives are rational, business rational, then some form of return for the investments, such as ROI, or ROA, or RONA, will convince them. ROI is a calculation, return minus investments divided by investments. The late Philip Crosby coined the phrase, quality is free. That's often met with a lot of skepticism, but it can be free. There's just an upfront investment to be made in order to gain your investment back plus that return, making it better than free. I'd also like to include some thoughts from Neil Rackham of Spin Selling fame, who I happened to have a chance to work with back in the early 80s at Motorola and again in the early 2000s. Crosby brought to the forefront the concept of the cost of conformance, the cost to bring things into standard, the cost to make things as perfect as required. But also he helped popularize the concept of the costs of nonconformance, the costs for doing nothing at all in response to problems or opportunities. In return on investment, the I, investment, is equivalent to the costs of conformance. The R, the returns, are the equivalent of the costs of nonconformance. If you make an investment to conform, you'll do away with those costs of nonconformance. Again, return on investments equals return minus the investment costs divided by the investment costs. That'll give you a return on investment ratio. Similarly, ROI can be calculated using the cost of nonconformance and the cost of conformance using this formula. Same thing. On to Spin Selling from the Huthaway Group, of which Neil Rackham was the founder and the principal in that organization for many years. Spin is a win-win sales philosophy. SPIN stands for Situation, Problems, Implications, and Needs Payoff. The S in SPIN, Situation, involves the salesperson asking lots of questions, not proposing solutions prematurely, not touting the features and benefits of their product or service, but trying to understand the situation of the client. Like any good lawyer, they're asking questions that they know the answer to, or suspect they know the answer to. They're trying to uncover problems in that situation so they can carry forward with the types of questions that SPIN guides one to do. Once problems are uncovered in the situation, the salesperson would ask many questions about those problems, trying to find the implications. Even when they may know the answers themselves, what they want is for the customer or the client to articulate the implications of those problems so that it's in the voice of the customer. Once those implications have been pinned down and you can sort the bigger implications from the smaller implications, such as the low-hanging fruit, what you want is the big potatoes rather than the little potatoes. And you want the customer to acknowledge that through the question and answer dialogue that the salesperson is facilitating. Quite Socratic. needs payoff is where the salesperson gets the customer to help them understand what is it worth. If we have this situation with these problems, and we pick this problem, and we see that the implication is rather large, would I calculate its value, its worth, this way or that way or how? Many times clients are willing to share this because they can see where this leads. This leads to a needs payoff for them. The needs payoff are the returns, or they are the cost of nonconformance. Again, that's the same thing. Return minus investments divided by investments will give you ROI. And the cost of nonconformance minus the cost of conformance divided by the cost of conformance will also give you ROI. Adapt this to your situation. In telling and selling your story for investing in quality, walk through the win-win spin. But that may not always be appropriate. Executives may not have the time to listen to the entire dialogue and rationale unravel in front of them. You may need to start with the end, the bottom line, in great detail. Not just that the butler did it and not the maid, but all the details about the butler did it and why do you really think so? Or, if you can, start with the end, the bottom line, but more as a tease. If your story is not too long, in your situation, your executives may tolerate listening to the unraveling rationale that the spin framework will provide you with. Always adapt to your situation, adapt to your situation, adapt to your situation, adapt to your situation. Need we say it one more time? Adapt to your situation. I come at performance improvement using various models. One of them that was quite key for me back in 1981 was the Ishikawa diagram. It provided a simple framework to analyze any process or any cluster of processes or any department's cluster of processes or function or business unit or enterprise. One could look at the four variables, non-politically correct, course, this was the 1980s, of men, materials, methods, and machines. I come at performance improvement through the lens of the humans, the men, the women, the people. It's not about learning, it's about performance. Performance competence is the ability to perform tasks, to produce outputs, to all of the stakeholder requirements for task performance and the outputs produced. Again, I'm part of the ASQ Influential Voices program, and while I receive a variety of quality resources as honorarium from ASQ, in exchange for my commitments, the thoughts and opinions expressed on my blog and in this video are my own. To learn more about quality, see them at their website. ASQ.org.